Hey guys, this is Rishikesh Kaule and welcome back to another S/4HANA video. So topic for this video is how to assign a purchasing organization to a plant or a company code. Okay, so for that we'll begin for the video. For that we need to enter T-code SPRO. SPRO T-code is for the configuration purpose. All types of configurations for all modules in SAP are done with SPRO T-code. Okay, so after coming to this screen, we'll go to SAP reference IMG. Okay, so this is the screen where we actually have the drop downs from where we can just select what we want to configure. So for purchasing organization assignment, we'll go to enterprise structure, then in assignment. Okay, yeah, the first thing is the purchasing organization, it should be created first and then it will be assigned. So for creation we have another video, you just can go and check for that video. So here we'll go for materials management, and here we have option like assign purchasing organization to plant and assign purchasing organization to company code. So for that we'll go for purchasing organization to plant, assign it to plant. Okay, after clicking here we get this option. So these are already assigned purchasing organizations to this particular plant. So when we want to add something, we need to click on new entries. After this you have the first option is purchasing organization. So what is your purchasing organization which you have created, that you need to select. Suppose now in our case it is KB01, so I'll just take a search for that. Okay, so this is that. I'll just click here, enter, and I need to, okay, sorry, I just need to go back again and new entry once again, KB01, and then I need to enter the plant. So what is the plant that if we want to search, that is also KB01, and in usual cases you know that what is your plant. So I'll just select this and I'll click on enter. So okay, this is like the purchasing organization and the plant. Usually when the purchasing is done from the plant and there is only one team, so we have one purchasing organization, so we have assigned this directly. In other cases, if your plant has multiple groups working for purchasing, you can have multiple purchasing organization and you can just get your organizations here and the same plant here. Okay, so after this I'll click on save at the right hand bottom side, and okay, it is saved in the request. So if I go back, I can see it here. If I go for positions and KB01, so this was the previously what it is blank that we will be deleting. So this is what we have created. Okay, so this is the way how we create a how we assign a purchasing organization to a plant. Now we'll check for how we assign a purchasing organization to a company code. So when I'll click here, so we'll get the same type of drop down here. So we have the purchasing organization and we need to assign the company code to that purchasing organization. So I'll go in positions and I'll go for our purchasing organization KB01. So okay, it is there, and I'll select for a company code that we have created. What is ours? It is KB00. Okay, so Kaule Brothers Limited. So I'll just click on here and I'll click on enter. So now this purchasing organization will be used for centralized purchase from your company level, like from your headquarters suppose in that case. So usually we have different purchasing organization for company code level and different for purchasing or plant level. Okay, so this was just to show you how we can assign, but in this case you can, it is mostly like a different purchasing organization than what is assigned to the plant. Okay, so just to save this, I'll again delete this because we are not going to work for both the things, plant and company code. I'll just save it. Okay, So this is now, I'll just go back. No, it is no back here. You can see this is only the display mode, if we can say. So here it is, our purchasing organization is assigned to the company code. That's it. Okay. So anything regarding, apart from this, anything regarding trainings like personal or industrial training, end user trainings, you can just connect with me. And yes, don't forget to subscribe our channel. This will help you to learn SAP S4HANA sourcing and procurement. Thank you.